Yeah, okay. So now, today we are going to discuss the subject. We are going to have a discussion to extend our mechatronics subject. Sorry. So, first of all, yes. Mechatronics. So we are today is the 2nd of 11th 2020. Okay, so we have discussed about the histogram and several type of distribution. Generally today we are going to focus on the only the normal distribution, right? So in the histogram we have already seen, if this topic is covered na Aditya, histogram we have covered in the previous class or not?
Sir, starting ke cover kiya tha sir.
Starting kiya tha cover. ठीक है, ठीक है, okay.
Yes, yes.
Let's okay, okay, no problem. So today I have switched off my video because I'm connected with the help of mobile phone, and maybe due to some poor connectivity, maybe some sound will be interrupted in between. Therefore, I have kept the video off. Hope you not be disturbed. So, okay. So, in the histogram techniques, first what we have to do first. Let's say we have different measurements, 10 different measurements. Let's say 26, 24, 26, 28, 23, 24, 25. 24, 26 and 25. Let's say this one is the our measurements. Okay, so when we are going to discuss these things, then let's say our different values, the different value it is represent. I am representing this one by the xk, right? So x1 is like you know just we have first of all write this sequence in the ascending order, okay? And then we have written like 23, then 24, then 25, then 26, and then 27, and last 28, right? Now what is the number of occurrence of the these values we have to note, okay? So this is represented by nk. So in this sequence you can see the number of 23 have come, I think, one time. So we have written here one. In a similar way, the 24 comes three times. 25 is coming two times. 26 is coming three times. 27 is coming zero times. And 28 is coming one times, right? So based on this measurement, we have here xk means x1 is nothing but this one. This is the x1, this is the x2, this is the x3, and so on, right? So the mean x bar, the mean is nothing, the summation of xi where I divided by n, right? So 23 plus 24 plus dot 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 up to the 28, when you calculated and divided by the total number of experiment, that is a 10, then you got the same result, that is the mean, right? This is the mean. Another way to calculate the mean, this equation may be modified. Like let's say x bar, just to writing the x bar like this one. Let's say 23 comes one time, so this is the 23 into 1, right? Plus 24 into 3, because 24 comes three times. And plus 25 into 2 times and so on, the number of n, the n multiplied by xk, right, up to the 28, multiplied divided by the 10, this will give again the mean, right? It will again represent the mean value. So this equation is written in the form of weighted. So the weighted sum is represented like this: summation of xk multiplied by the nk divided by the total number of experiment n, and this summation is starting with a k, right? So this is the x bar, this is the mean value. You can write like this also, right? So this is a modified version of the mean, right? Now from the next part.
Hello.
Yeah.
सर पहला वाला जो मेन निकाले उसमें n 10 कैसे हो
गया? N is the number of experiment. N is the number of experiment. You can see here.
सबसे पहला वाला जो करता है हमने.
हाँ पहला वाला भी वही है. देखो आप 25 से लेकर this is the this one is your experiment 26 24 26 28 23 this is the number 10 number na 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 right
yes sir
is it clear
yes sir
there are 10 number of experiment have been done okay in which 23 comes once by one times 24 come three times and so on right so we have multiplied the number of xk with the number of nk and then we have
pehla wala jo tha main
pehla wala hi to hai
jahan pe 23 plus 24 wo jo upar k 23 plus 24 plus 28
dekho 23 plus 23 ek bar hai right 24 aapka 3 times hai to just to write 24 plus 24 plus 24 like this
wo 24 lagata teen bar add
kiya exactly tabhi to hoga na tabhi to hoga तीन टाइम लिखे तभी तो हो पाएगा ना फिर 24 के बाद आपने लिखा व्हाट एवर द वैल्यू 25 प्लस 25 प्स 25 देन 26
सर हमको लगा 23 प्लस 24 प्लस 25
एग्जैक्टली 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 इज इट क्लियर माधव क्लियर
यस सर
ओके सो नाउ सो इट मींस व्हेन So this equation represents nothing like the weighted sum, right? This is the weighted sum equation. Okay. So why it is weighted sum? Because xk is weighted. Xk is weighted, right? By the number of, by the number of times it occurred, right? It occurred, nk. So xk is weighted by the sum nk. Now we have also seen that summation of nk if we take the sum of all the value of nk can it represent the number n yes or no let's say the occurrence of 23 is one time right The occurrence of 24 is 3 times. The occurrence of let's say 25 is 2 times. When we add all the number, it represents the 10, and 10 is nothing but your capital N, right? So summation of NK is basically a capital N, right? So now. Now, so the idea. The idea of the discussion is like that. So let's say if we say the result x equals to 24. Let's say x equal to 24 was obtained 3 times. Right? You can see here the 24 is occurring 3 times. So can we write like this? X equal to 24. The measurement, the probability of measurement of 24 is nothing but the 3 by 10. Yes or no? Yes or no? So 3 by 10 of all the measurement of all our measurement, the occurrence of X 24 like this. Yes or no? Right. So in other words, we can write here the NK that is the number of times. The result xk occurred. The xk occurred like this. So what is this? So we are going to introduce here the terms, new terms. That is the f of k, capital F of k. What is fk? Fk is nothing. This is the nk, right? This is the nk of 24. You can say here, na three. What is the three? 3 is the number of repetition of 24, that is the x of, let's say, 22. x2 is the 24, and it repeats 3 times. So this is the nk, this is the capital N. So it represents the probability of occurring the x2. Okay, so similarly we can say that the probability of fk in the terms of nk divided by the total number of n, right? So this is the mathematical term for the number of times of result xk occurred, right? So it is nothing but the fraction, it is nothing but the fraction of our capital N that gives the result xk, right? Now this fk are said to specify, here we are saying that this is the probability of occurrence of 24 or x2 xk in the terms of nk divided by n, right? So here it is also called as probability, or also called the distribution, right? So in the case of the statistics, we are saying that fk are said to be specified the distribution, right? In the statistics, it is known as the distribution, right? So what does this distribution represent? This distribution represents our measurement where distributed among the different possible value, right? So this is the sum. Now come to the next point. We are going to extend our discussion.
Hello.
Wait for a minute. Okay. So now when you're talking about the mean x bar, now the modified, because you know, here you can see here the fk represent the nk by n, okay, and we have already represented the mean was, the equation for the mean was weighted sum was xk into nk divided by n, right? And we already have discussed the summation of nk is nothing but the capital N. So therefore now, and also fk represents the nk by n, right? nk by n, okay? So we can simply written here as x bar is nothing but the summation of k, x of k into fk. So this is the new modified equation for the mean, right? So you have to memorize this, okay? So you can say here x bar is the mean, okay, or this mean is nothing but the weighted sum of all the different values xk obtained with each xk weighted by the fraction of times kya hoga, it occurred, right? Kitni bar occurred hua. So it occurred in the terms of fk. So this is the, you know, mean. You can represent the mean like this one also, right? So one more thing is there. Total number of probability, that is the, you can write like this, the maximum fk, the summation of this fk is nothing but, you know, the 100%, right? The nk upon capital N, the maximum number is nothing but the 1. Yes or no, the students, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we can write like this, the summation of fk is equal to 1. Okay. Okay. So the maximum, the possible, when we add up the fraction fk for all possible results xk, we must get the value 1, right? So you can also normalize the value 1 also, right? So that normalization is called the normalization condition, right? Now I am going to represent that these equation, these numbers, this represent these measurements with the help of some histogram, right? So now you can see the variation by picture, so that you can understand the normal distribution, the concept of the normal distribution, how the normal distribution has evolved, what is the need for that normal distribution. Let's say this is the fk, this is the xk. Okay, so you can say here 22 is coming, right? We are written 0, 0.1, 10%, 20. Okay, this is the 20, 0.2 and 0.3, right? So you can say 22 is coming, you know, 0 times, 23 is coming 1 time, 24 is coming 3 times, right? 24 is coming 3 times, 25 is coming 2 times, 26 is coming 3 times. With the help of histogram, we are representing this. 27, 0 and 28, I think, 1 time. Okay. So based on this, we can draw the histogram for 10 measurements of length x, right? So the vertical, what is the vertical axis representing? What it shows? The vertical axis shows the fraction of times fk that each value xk was observed, right? So you can also say that, right? Like let's say 23, the occurrence of 23 is 1 time, so you can say 0.1 divided by, when multiplied by the 10, it becomes 1 time, right? Is it okay? Yes or no? Tell me. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
If you have any doubt, you can ask at any moment. Right. So this type of histogram, this type of simple histogram may be called as a bar histogram. Right? So, because here the vertical bars representing the nothing but the xk, right? So, this kind of histogram is very appropriate whenever the value xk are tidily expressed, right? Tidily expressed with the integer value, right? So you can see the another example, let's say where the tidily spaced types of experiment, you know, may be occurred. Let's say the student scored on the examination are usually integer, right. So that are displayed conveniently using with the help of bar histogram only, right? So now the another way of representing this one, because where the marks or where the datas or whether measurements are very tightly spaced, in that point you can know you can take the beans. Beans means you can write here a bar histogram of these 10 values would consist of 10 separate bar. 10 separate bar, right? All the same height. If it will occur like that. So I'm leave that. This is not required. Okay. Now I'm coming to the next part. So let's say we are defining these things in the terms of beans. Beans means interval, right? So beans are in terms of interval. The another way of representing the histogram in terms of bean or interval, like this, you can see here with the example, you can understand it better. Let's say we have the 10 measurement, same, we have the 10 measurement, right? But it has been grouped into beans. Beans means, let's say this is the beans, this is the interval. Now this is the observation in bean. So we have divided our beans like this, our measurement like this. 22, how many values are occurred in between the 22 and 23? In similar 23 to 24, in similar 24 to 25, right? Here the interval value is 1. 25 to 26 and 26 to 27, right? And then right? You can observe here, the value occurred like this. 20, this is the 3, this is the 4, this is the 1, this is the 4, this is the 1, this is the 0. Okay. So now the diagram for the histogram is slightly changed, and it takes the pictorial diagram like this. When you draw, this is the 22, this is the 23, okay, this is the 22, this is the 23, 24, 25, right, 26, 27, and then 28, right? So it's often like 0.1, 0.2, and 0.3, and last 0.4, right? So 0.1 say yahan se aise, right? And then 23 to 24 mein jitna hai aap usko dekh lo. So it's say to 3, so aap isko aise draw kar 3, sorry, okay? So 23 to 24 look like this. And then the value 24 to 25 is 1. So 24 to 25 is again 1, right? Then 25 to 26 is 4. So it will go upper 24 and then 26. And then 26 to 27 is 1 again. So it will take like this one, right? And then 0. So finally this is 0, right? So this the picture is coming like this, right? So the size of bean here is 1. So now the pictorial, the histogram is representing like this, right? And the bean, the size of the bean, let's say this is the one bean. So bean size, and it is represented by the delta k, right? It is represented by the delta k. Here, this is for the n, is the number of 10 experiment. Here, the bean size is delta 1. Delta k is 1, right? So, I hope you understand it, right? So, nothing, the fk into delta k now becomes the fraction of measurement. Same thing here. Fraction of measurement in the kth bean, right? Fk into delta k represent the fraction of measurement in the kth bean. Okay, Why? Because what is the FK? What is the FK? FK is your height. Height of the whatever the value, vertical axis. You can say vertical axis, right? On the vertical axis. And delta K is the V. Right? So ultimately, when you add all these things, you got the, you know, the area. Right? Now, next is your limiting distribution. And why we are saying to the limiting distribution? Because let's say your number of experiment is going to increase. In most of the experiment, as the number of measurement increases, the histogram begins to take a definite, called as a simple shape. You can also see here, this is the, you know, the number of experiment is very, very less. N is very, very less. N equals to 10. When you increase the number of the experiment, when you increase the number of 10 to, let's say, 100, then same experiment when you done, okay, let's say the 23 will come 0 times, 1 times, 50 times, 60 times, like this. So for, let's say, I am taking one example, the N is equals to, now we have increased from 10 to 100, right? This is the 0, this is 0.1, this is 0.2, this is 0.3 and 0.4, right? This is the 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, that's the 28. So this is the 0, then this is like this one, when, and 0.4, okay, 0.4, 25, then come to the 0.3, like this, okay, you can take any example. When your experiment is larger, right, like this one. So you can see here, from this figure, from with the help, you can check here with this figure number, let's say this is a figure number one. This is a figure number one. So there is no symmetry here, right? There is no symmetry in this picture. But when you increase the number of experiment, it is going to take a one type of, you know, the shape, right? The shape is looking like this one. Now, as you increase the more number, picture, your histogram will take a simple bell shaped, right? Suppose that, let's say you have taken the experiment, you have all more increases, you have increases more number of the experiment from N to 10 to 100, and then 100 to, let's say, 1000. Now, when you draw, let's say, what happens, see. The picture, what happened to this? Let's say this is the FK, this is the XK, right? And the 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, and 0.4, right? This is the 20, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, and then let's say 28, right? Now we are going to draw this one. So just I'm drawing. I'm not explaining how many times it will occur, right? So with the help of diagram, just I am showing you, it takes like the picture, this one. So up to the 25.5, it takes the maximum value. This is the maximum value maybe, okay. sorry, this is the maximum value it will take here at the 25.5, like this one, right? And then again the value is decreasing like this one, like this, like this. Okay, so you can see when you're going to draw this picture, this will take totally bell shaped. When you increases your experiment from 10 to 100, 100 to 1000, and when to take the number of infinite number, right? When you take the infinite number of experiment, it will totally take the bell shaped, right? Bell shaped. So bell shaped means it is simply looking like this one. Okay. So let's say it. What it represent? This represent what is this? This represent fx. This represent fx, right? And let's say this is the x. So this is the x plus delta x, right? What is this? 24, 25, 26. This is the x. This is the x plus delta x, right? This is the x. Axis is x. X is your x, right? This is the axis is x. So when you say about the, when you take the area fx into dx, so what it represent? What it represent? It represent the fraction of measurement, the fraction of measurement that fall between x and x plus dx. Am I right? What it represent? It represent the fraction of measurement that fall between x plus dx. इसके बीच में कितना आपका फ्रैक्शन आ रहा है? फ्रैक्शन ऑफ मेजरमेंट 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, यही तो रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, यस और नो? राइट? सो नाउ इन मोर प्रिसाइज वे व्हेन यू टेक लाइक दिस, व्हेन यू सेइंग लाइक दिस, लेट्स से दिस इज द ए, दिस इज द बी, ओके, दिस इज द ए, दिस इज द बी, this one the x and this one is the total fx. So we can write here integral from a to b fx dx. Fx dx is nothing but the, can anybody tell me what is this? What the this is also the fraction of measurement lying between the, tell me, the student,
a and b.
So the fraction of measurement, that fall between A and B, right? So finally, you can say here, then I will wrap up this one. You can say here, as the number of interval, as the number of measurement will increases, right? The fx dx will represent the, actually this is the fraction of measurement, right? The fraction of measurement, you can say that this represents the distribution. We have already told this represents the distribution, and you know the distribution is nothing but the probability, right? So probability of occurrence. So you can say here probability that any one measurement, that any one measurement will give an answer between x and x plus dx, right? Now you tell me what is the, suppose that when you have taken the large number of experiment, means let's say you have taken infinite number of, minus infinite to infinite. Can you tell me what is equal to this one? Minus infinity to infinity fx dx equal to what? Tell me. What it represent?
Sir, one
over. A to B fx dx. What does it represent? It represents the number of fraction of measurement. So let's say we have measuring we have measuring from minus infinite to plus infinite, then it will represent overall area. And we already said the total area of this is 100%. So you can say this is the fundamentals of the distribution, of the limited distribution, right? Is it clear? Okay. Now I'm coming to the next part, that is your distribution. So there are two, you have understand this will take the bell shape. This will take the bell shape, and the bell shape having two types. Let's say this is one of the bell shape, and another bell shape is like this one. And you told me what is the significance of this bell shape. Let's say we have the two types of the bell shape occurred. The first one is this one, figure one, and let's say this is the figure two. What the difference, what it says, what the significance? This is the fx, this is the x. Let's say we have done the infinite number of experiment and occurred like this one, this two types of histogram types. Okay, so now tell me, this is a limiting distribution we occurred, right? So tell me what is the significance, what it says.
Sir, yahi ki ek value concentrated hai.
Kya keh rahe ho? Ha madam,
spread hai sir, ek concentrated hai, matlab ki uske fraction
in the term of
maximum hai uski.
Yes, in the terms of measurement isko kya kahenge
sir? Dono pehle wale ka data bahut close hai सबके ऑब्जर्वेशंस, और दूसरे का बहुत ज्यादा डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ज्यादा है दूसरे
एक्यूरेट. ओके, प्रेसिजन बोल सकते हैं.
ओके, एनीवन, प्रमोद, यू वांट टू से एनीथिंग, यू वांट टू ऐड समथिंग?
नहीं सर, ये था कि हां डाटा डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कम है और एक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ज्यादा है.
ओके, मुस्कान,
प्रिसाइज डेटा.
मुस्कान, यू वांट टू से समथिंग? नो
नो सर, सेम है, एक में डाटा प्रिसाइज होगा, एक ही बहुत ज्यादा है और दूसरे में डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ज्यादा है.
व्हिच वन इज मोर प्रिसाइज, व्हिच वन इज लो प्रिसाइज? इन द टर्म ऑफ प्रिसीजन कैन यू डिफरेंशिएट दिस वन, व्हिच वन इज द मोर प्रिसाइज एंड व्हिच वन इज द लो प्रिसाइज?
नो सर, सॉरी, नो प्रिसाइज, आई वाज सेइंग अबाउट द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द डाटा. इन फर्स्ट वन
डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डाटा, यस, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डाटा. So which one has a more precise distribution? High precise distribution. Okay, no problem. So you can conclude like that. Which one is the more concentrated, as Madhav said? Which one is the more concentrated? You can say that which has the high precision. High precision, right? High precision distribution. However, okay, and in the second case, this one is the low precision. Low, low precision, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So now come to the next part. As we know that we have represented the mean value like that, x bar is nothing but the xk fk, right? So now in the terms of the x bar is again modified, we can write here in the terms of this one. Okay, the minus infinite to infinite x of fx dx, fx of fx dx. This is again representing the same, because it is represent, this represent fx dx represent, you know, the distribution when you multiply it by this weighted sum. Again, it becomes the mean, right? So this one is the one way. Now I am coming to the next part, that the normal distribution. And in the normal distribution, when this is the same with the normal distribution basically that what we have studied in this. So now that the property of this normal distribution is like this, when you draw the fx dx, okay, so this is the, let's say, f z. Why I'm taking f z? It has also significance. I will cover it very soon. What is the f z? Now come to this part. This is the normal, this is generally the normal distribution curve. Okay, this is the also part of the Gaussian curve. This is the also called as the standard Gaussian curve, right? Gaussian curve. So there is some mathematics we are coming on this also. So it is very symmetrical. This is very, very symmetrical. It is also called the normal distribution. Normal distribution. So how the normal, what is the concept of normal distribution? When you increase the number of experiment, when you take the high number, large number of infinite number of okay, so when you take the large number of measurement or infinite number of measurement, the automatically your distribution will take this type of picture, right? And there is some property of this picture also. First property is the area under this, area under the curve is 100%. Area under the curve is 100%. Okay. Next part is the this point is called as the point of inflection. Point of inflection. What is the point of inflection? Because when you draw this picture, when you precisely draw the picture, the nature of this picture is like here it is called the convexity, right? Here the convexity, the nature of the convexity is changing from this point or somewhere any point. At that point where the nature is changing from convexity to concavity, that point is known as point of inflection. So it is very important, maybe it's asked in many of the exam, what is the point of inflection of the distribution. So always remember, changing from convexity to concavity, not from the concavity to convexity, right? So this is a very convex. We are changing our nature, the curve is changing the nature of the convexity to concavity, right? Now, it is also true, the third property of this one is the bilateral, it is a bilateral symmetrical. Bilateral symmetrical. It means, what is the bilateral symmetrical? It means the nature is totally same in between this side and this side also, right? So this is a zero, right? Other point is maybe noted like this. For the normal distribution, the mean value is equal to the median value and equal to the mode value. Both are the same because we have taken an infinite number of experiments. Median, mean, median, mode are the same for the normal distribution. Now come to some mathematical equation so that you can understand, right? So one more thing, that is your equation. Come to the next part. We have 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, we can finish it. So it is very important. It is very important for the examination point of view. The mathematical function that describe the bell shaped, जो ऊपर आपको मैंने दिखाया है, the bell shaped curve, as we already know, this is called as normal distribution, and the mathematical equation for this one is e to the power The prototype, basically, you can say it is a prototype, right? Prototype equation. So e to the power minus of x square divided by 2 sigma square. So what is sigma? Okay, what is sigma? Sigma is nothing but it is a fixed parameter. It is a fixed parameter, right? And it is called as the width parameter, right? So in the picture, what is there? What is that? You can visualize like that. I'm drawing the picture. We are drawing two picture. First picture is like this one. Okay, and second picture is like this one. Okay, so again, one is a more precise, another is a less precise. So in this case, our sigma value, the width parameter is a large. However, in this case, the sigma value is very, very small. Comparative to this one, the sigma value is small, right? So this value is zero. So when x equal to zero, in this equation, this represents the Gaussian distribution or the normal distribution, generally. Okay, and you know when you put the value x equal to zero, what it becomes? The Gauss function becomes, right? This is the Gauss function. So the Gauss function become 1, right? And it will not change because it is same for the x and minus x. It will be the same for the x and minus x when you put the x equal to 0, okay? So it is this function is completely symmetrical about x equal to 0. Therefore, it is a completely symmetrical about x equal to 0 when you put for the x or the minus x, right? So as x moves away from the 0 in either any direction, the x square by 2 sigma square increases quickly if sigma is small, and more slowly if sigma is large. You can see from the picture, right? So you can write also, as x moves away, it is the important point you can write here. As x moves away from 0 in either direction, x square by 2 sigma square increases, right? But how the nature of the increment is, okay? So it will increase quickly. It will increase quickly if sigma is small. Right? And more slowly if sigma is large, right? So it is like that. It's totally symmetrical about x equal to 0, you understand? So now, if it is not symmetrical about, let's say, x equal to 0, so how it can be represented? The Gaussian function becomes, if it is not symmetrical about x equal to 0, if it is symmetrical about x, capital X, then we have to apply the shifting property, right? Which shifting property? E to the power x minus capital X square divided by 2 sigma square. Is it clear? Yes or no? Tell me. Are haiya na bol bhai.
Yes, sir.
So where the maximum value will occur? Tell me, where the one will occur from the equation? A small x equal to? Yes.
Capital X.
Yes or no? This when, yes. It will, the value of,
yes, sir.
the value of x, when you put x capital X, it becomes zero, and it will become maximum. The maximum value one. Yes or no? अरे हाँ यार ना बोलो भाई.
Yes sir.
So the function integral on either of x equal to capital. ये symmetrical कहाँ हो जाएगा? Capital X के अराउंड. ठीक है? As shown in the figure. Right? Now, from the next mathematics, we have 5 minutes. So in 5 minutes, we can finish it. Okay. So as we know that the integration from minus infinity to infinity fx dx equal to 1, we have already done. Okay. So now we have equalized this equation number, let's say 1. The how the normalization will taken, fx is equal to nothing. We already have done, right? What is the value of fx? Fx is the Gaussian function. So Gaussian function is nothing but the e to the power minus of x minus capital X square divided by 2 sigma square, and we normalize by the capital N. N is nothing but the normalization factor. N is capital N is your normalization factor. Normalization factor, right? Normalization factor. We have taken the fx for the Gaussian function. Now we want to calculate. We want to solve the above equation for the Gaussian function, right? So our equation becomes like this: minus infinite to infinite fx dx equal to minus infinite to infinite capital N to the power minus of x minus capital X square divided by 2 sigma square dx, right? And now what we are just taking x, let's say let x minus capital X represent y, and therefore dx equal to becomes dy. Our equation becomes n minus infinite to infinite e to the power nothing but the minus y square divided by 2 sigma square dy, right? Based on this, now some more mathematics will involve. Let's say we defined y by sigma as equals to z. Y by sigma equal to z. Accordingly, the dy, when you take the dy, it becomes sigma dz. Dy, when you take the dy differentiation, then it becomes sigma into dz, right? Just to try to solve this above equation, based on this, it becomes n sigma minus infinite to infinite e to the power minus z square divided by 2 dz. Okay, so the above equation, the first diagram that we in which we have seen the inflection, that function was in the terms of fz. You can see. Okay, now one more thing, I'm not going to the solution of that function, but from the mathematics we know that minus the integration of minus infinite to infinite e to the power minus z square divided by 2 dz is equals to root under 2 pi. We already have known. You can also, it is your part, you can solve it with the help of some tools. Okay. So now with the help of this result, our final equation minus infinite fx dx becomes fx dx becomes n sigma, or the solution of this equation is this one. Therefore, it is the root under 2 pi, and we already know the summation of the integration value of this value, and this value is nothing but the 1. this value is nothing but the one, right? So what is the normalization factor? The normalization factor becomes n equal to nothing but the one upon sigma root under 2 pi. So most of the times it will ask in your examination, what is the normalization factor, right? So this is the
pi root ke andar hi hai.
Haan, bilkul pi under root under 2 pi. The solution of this function is root under 2 pi. Okay. So this is called as this form, this normalization factor is generally known as, you know, Gauss or normal distribution function. Normal distribution function. Haan? So it is nothing but, you know, the function, it is generally represented by, you know, like Gaussian function is gx sigma x, aise karke represent karte hain kabhi kabhi, theek hai. So baharal hamara main idea hai, our idea is nothing but our conclusion, final conclusion is this, and then I will stop the our discussion. G of x sigma x is equal to nothing but the sigma root under 2 pi, okay, e to the power, this is the n, okay. So how x minus capital X square divided by 2 sigma square. This is the Gaussian function. We have to decide this one, right? ये आपको करना है, ठीक है जी? Okay, so I'm not going to the details of more Gaussian function, right? Just we have stopped our discussion, and then tomorrow we will start with the, you know, limiting error, combination of how the limiting error, how the uncertainty of the measurements can be evaluated or computed, right? So tomorrow we will discuss at our time. So thank you. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Is it okay?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So I am just stopping our recording.